Hello. I'm Sam. We will set up a ColdFusion server on this Windows desktop. If we are going to code in ColdFusion, we need a ColdFusion application server to run our code. When it comes to ColdFusion, we have two main ColdFusion engines. We have Adobe ColdFusion, a paid enterprise application server. There is a free developer edition as well. Or we have Lucee, a free, open-source CFM engine. I use Lucee on most of my production servers. Today, we are going to set up Lucee Express Edition. It is a simple zip file with no installation. So we can start coding right away. Let's download the Express Edition. Lucee, and Adobe ColdFusion both, run on Java. Even though, standalone editions come with Java packed inside, the Express Edition does not. We have to make sure, we have Java on this computer. Before we start with Lucee, let's check do we have Java. Go to the command line, type Java, and if you get a Java is not recognized as an internal or external command message, you do not have Java. I have Java on this computer already, so I don't get an error. Instead, I get the help section. That is what I am expecting. If you do not have Java installed, pause this video. Google, download Java, install it, and return to the video. Lucee Express zip file download completed. I'm going to unzip it onto the desktop. Now, let's start the Lucee server. There is no installation. We can start Lucee Express with the startup.bat file. Oh! We got an error. There are different types of Java runtimes. I have what is called Open Java. Looks like Lucee cannot find it automatically. That is okay. We are going to fix it. If you do not get this error, you can skip this section. Let me explain. The startup.bat file is trying to automatically locate the Java settings, but this computer's settings are different. Bat files are text-based files, which means we can edit them with any text editor you have. I'm using Sublime Text. This is where it is looking for the Java version. Let me find what version of Java I have. Let's go to the command prompt and find it. Found it. Copy it. Set the value here and comment out this line where it automatically looks for the Java version. Comment syntax in bat files is REM, which stands for remarks. Let's save the file. Let's rerun this. Good. The first error is gone. Now it is looking for Java directory. Let's find the Java directory location too. We can do that by typing where Java. We only need the path up to /bin when you get the Java path. We don't need the rest. Now let's set the path value as well. Comment out this line where it automatically looks for the directory path. Let's run again. It will take about 10 to 20 seconds. If you run this for the first time, the Windows firewall might prompt you with an access request. Lucee Express is running. Our setup is complete. Let's see how it works. Open the browser and go to localhost on port 8888. Lucee Express Edition, by default, runs on port 8888. You should see this welcome page. Congratulations. If you have some other program already running on the same port, or if you want to switch this to run on a different port, like port 80, it is easy to do that. Let me show you how. Port 80 is the default HTTP port. Go to configuration folder. Open up server.xml. And edit this to port 80. Restart Lucee. Now it is running on default port 80. This is optional, of course. If you don't know what a network port is in a computer, it is just like real-world seaports or an airport, except, we name network ports with unique numbers. And one application takes over complete ownership of a port at a given time. For example, when Lucee uses port 80, no other program can use that port. It gets locked up. Localhost is equivalent to saying in English, I am, or, myself. We are telling the browser to go to port 80 of this computer. How can we make a ColdFusion page ourselves and run it in our new setup? That is, what we want to do. Right? Let's go to the webops/root folder. This index.cfm is the welcome page. Let it be for now, and let's create our own hello.cfm next to it. ColdFusion use.cfm extension. Let's run our hello.cfm through the browser. It worked. All is fine. We can see our hello world. Let's write our first ColdFusion code too. I will explain these in the following video. There we go. Refresh. New time. Our setup is functioning. CFM is working. This is the time to hit that like button because you watched it so far. Isn't it? Liked it? Yes? My ColdFusion comrades, thank you very much for the thumbs up. If you are new to server-side programming, always remember you must request your file through the web server. Your code won't get compiled if you open the file directly, without asking it through the web server, using your browser. If you see the refuse to connect error message, your Lucee server is not running. Let me turn off the Lucee server instance and refresh the page. See that? Let's see you in the following video and learn some ColdFusion coding basics. Now watch out for all those little things when running a web server on your workstation.